Golf shoes are taking on all sorts of forms these days, and one of the areas is stability. And I caught up with Richard Fryer of FootJoy to speak about their new M Project shoe and ask him where does this fit in terms of their range, in terms of stability and performance.
Well, mine's very interesting. We've got a number of shoes that offer a huge amount of stability. For example, XPS, the most stable shoe on the planet. Now, this is a shoe that kind of sits at the other end of the spectrum. What we're trying to achieve with M Project is to allow for the golfer to really move through the shot, and it's natural motion. That's really the ethos behind it. We've achieved that through the construction, minimal construction, so the golfer can really feel what's going on underneath. Now, some people say, "Well, does that mean stability is dead? You're not looking for that anymore." Absolutely not. For the majority of golfers, a stable shoe is going to suit their game, it's going to give them better balance, it's going to enable them to hit better golf shots. But there are a number of golfers out there that actually stability for them isn't actually what their swing needs. Now, the difficulty, of course, is, well, I'm a consumer, which one's for me? Well, to be honest, the best way to do it is to try them. Sympathy is to try them, wear them in the shop, try and hit a few shots in there. But the other thing to do, of course, is to talk to your local PGA professional. He'll know your game, he'll be able to say, actually, you know what, you don't quite get through the ball particularly well, maybe M Project might be a good shoe for you. Or vice versa, somebody who perhaps loses their balance, maybe a more stable shoe for them would be good. But the great thing with M Project is now we really have rounded off a very comprehensive line and have performance characteristics for every golfer's needs.
Well, you mentioned it's a very extensive range you've got here, and you've got the sort of lightweight shoes with spikeless and very high stability. How do you see your range developing moving forward?
We're constantly trying to keep up with fashion trends. Is one thing, obviously, the upper is the first thing anybody looks at on a golf shoe, so it needs to look the part. We have some very traditional contemporary designs like we have on FJ Icon, and then we have some more sporty aggressive designs on XPS, FJ Sport, or perhaps even M Project. Now, spikeless as a category is definitely growing. In the UK, we're still looking at kind of 90% of golfers wearing spikes, so I don't see the end of the spike shoe anytime soon. But spikeless is an interesting category. It's very it offers a huge amount of versatility. You put them on at home, you go straight to the golf course, you go straight on the range in the clubhouse, and they do offer, for certain golfers, they offer the stability and the comfort that they need. That said, when you look on tour and 97% are still wearing spikes, I think that tells quite a strong message as to the performance benefits of a spike golf shoe.
Do you think some people are just prioritising comfort and convenience over maybe choosing the right shoe and there's more or less stability than a spike shoe?
Yes, I think so, but ultimately performance, it will be very different for each golfer. For some people, perhaps an older golfer, for example, for them, a performance shoe is one that is super comfortable and means at the end of the round that their feet are very comfortable. And they're happy to give up perhaps that little bit of stability or that little bit of support during the round, because for them the more important thing is that they can comfortably walk 18 holes. Now, there'll be other golfers that say, well, actually, no, I'm not, most important thing is I have the highest performance gear, I need a stable shoe that's going to stand up against my swing, because I'm a big hard hitter. So performance ultimately for golfers is different depending on their own swings and their own performance characteristics.
You mentioned 97% of tour guys are still using spike shoes. Do you see maybe a long-term trend that spike shoes might be replaced by spikeless ones?
I think the percentage of spikeless will grow, but I think it's going to be fairly slow. With our tour players, we very much have an open book policy. We show them the FootJoy catalogue. They're always very keen to see the FootJoy catalogue. What are the new styles? What's coming? But we never say to a tour player, you must wear XPS, you must wear FJ Icon. They should be picking the products that are best suited for their game. And the fact that we have maybe one or two out of all of our vast range of tour players, only one or two have chosen to wear, say, contour casual or sports spikeless, I think that tells a message that they're picking the best performing product for them, and spikeless is in the minority, and I suspect it will remain there for quite some time.
So what is the most popular model that you have on tour?
The most popular model on tour by far is FJ Icon. Very much a performance shoe when you look at the outsole, but the upper, traditional, contemporary, the best materials, calfskin detail on the uppers, and not to mention the fact that you can personalise it through MyJoys. So if you look at players like Luke Donald, Bubba Watson wore a pair of MyJoys to win the Masters last year. That's something that the players are getting. They enjoy doing that just as much as we do when we're bored of a weekend.
Great, thanks, Richard. We enjoy talking to you. Thanks again.
You're welcome. Thank you.